to be a happy night.
I am happy. I'm very happy. For Linda.
We're all happy for you, Linda. Oh, Lind, you lucky stars.
Just imagine, Lind. After tomorrow, you'll have your own flat, your own fella, you'll be a married woman.
You'll have your own front room, your own Hoover, your own Teddy.
Your own husband.
Ah, yeah. Dave's great, isn't he? He's a great fella. He's really dynamic, isn't he?
Mm, he's good looking. Mm.
And he's a worker, isn't he?
I mean, he's not like some of them would lift a finger at someone, would they?
Ah, he's not like that, though.
I bet he helps in the house and that. I bet he does. Mm.
Some of them wouldn't, though, would they? Mm. My fella doesn't. He wouldn't lift a bloody finger. He wouldn't get out that chair if the roof was coming through. Idle, you know, that type. The kids call him the reluctant plumber. Because he never does a tap.
Her Dave won't be like that, though.
I know. Dave would be great in the house.
I bet he even helps when the little ones come along. Oh, God.
Will you shut up? For Christ's sake, Maureen, tonight's supposed to be a celebration, not a wake.
I am celebrating. I'm celebrating for Linda. It's just, I wish it was me.
Oh, well, never mind, Maureen.
Your turn will come.
Do you think so?
Do you really think so?
Yeah, you'll be all right. You've just got to meet the fella who appreciates your sort of looks.
Aww.
Well, you know,
I can't wait to see her in the church tomorrow.
Have you seen her dress, Mo?
Oh, when I was round there last week, her man said she'd show it to me. But I couldn't bring myself to look. I would have cried. I cried very easily.
We wouldn't have known.
I saw it. It is gorgeous, you know? Just off the shoulder.
It's a new length, isn't it?
With the lace across here, Mo.
The back's lovely, isn't it, Carol?
The back is superb. It's got no back.
Oh.
Haven't you seen it, Bernie?
No. I like to save her for the actual day. I like to get my first glimpse of it in the church.
That's nice, isn't it?
That's really nice, Fern.
Oh, we're all so happy for you, Linda.
What makes it really special is that it's Linda.
I know. I always thought Linda would be the last to get married, but she never got married at all.
What?
Oh, no, because she isn't eligible. She is. She's very eligible.
She could have been a model if she wanted to.
Oh, I know. No, I'm not saying that. What I mean is, Linda's always been sort of independent, hasn't she? Like, she wouldn't take things too seriously. And then she just announces she's getting married. And she's not even in the club or anything like that. Is she?
No! Love, Carol. Love changes you. Love makes you grow.
I'm glad. I'm so glad, Linda.
I know she'll be happy with Dave. Now, it'd be a different matter if it was someone like my fella. She was married. A man? My fella? He's an apology. I said to him last night, I was feeling a bit torn down, you know? And he's lying there, snoring. That type he is. Head hits the pillow and he's straight asleep. I said, here, it's a bloody good job they didn't have the trade's descriptions act when they christened you, Dick.
Go away, Bernie.
The poor fella's probably more mind with you. You'd be moaning about not getting enough if you were married to Michael Fassbender.
Ooh, I'd say me and Mike looking on like a house on fire.
Oh, imagine being married to someone like Fassbender. You'd have your own big house, servants, a swimming pool. Oh, the clothes you wanted.
It might all look glamorous, Carol, but fame has its drawbacks, though.
I'd risk it. Wouldn't you, Carol?
Whoa! Spill on me, Mickey!
No!
But honestly, Brady, it's true. The price of fame is a big one.
Speak
for yourself.
Oh,
what are they like, Carol?
Great.
Horrible.
Oh,
they're not
Blue films, it's just sex, you know, for the sake of it. With Titanic, it's all beautiful and romantic. Now, that's how sex should be, all soft and in colour.
That's how it should be, Carol.
But it never is, love.
It can be. With the right man, it can. I am not interested in fellas who want to make sex. I want a fella who makes love, not a fella who makes sex.
I just want a fella. Do you know when my fella was young?
Young? Christ, Bernie, he's only about 32 now, isn't he?
Yeah, but I mean, young on the inside. I mean, he's young on the outside.
But he's a geriatric inside.
No, but me and him were forced married. We went on a holiday to Cork Town. We went to the pictures one night in Gory, and we seen this film where this couple kept going down to the shore and making love.
Oh, I've seen that! It's great! Oh, the waves are lapping over them, and the sun setting, and the music. Oh, it's a great film.
It was really beautiful. Magic. And when it was over, me and my fella came out of the pictures and we walked down to the beach, and honest to God, it was just like in the film. Deserted it was, the beach. There was just us and the sound of the sea just softly lapping the shore.
Ah, isn't that lovely?
Sounds like paradise.
That's what it was like, honestly. That's just how I felt, like I was standing on the edge of paradise. And my fella got his arm around me and he started squeezed me in, and he said, I'll always remember. Do you know what he said?
Well, you getting them off yet, or what?
Can you imagine Leonardo DiCaprio saying that to Kate Winslet?
Do you fancy a leg over?
You see, Carol, it's only half of it you see in the films. And I'll tell you another thing the film didn't mention. The bloody sand gets everywhere.
Oh, we're having a great time, aren't we? Aren't we?
We were going to stay down there in Cortown, but we didn't. But you want to hear, my fella? When we're out having a few jars, he's always going on about the place. So I say, all right, come on, let's go, let's do it. But he wakes up the next morning and pretends he never says a thing. Suppose we live and die around here.
It's a dump, isn't it? It's like this place. Christ, look at it. Why can't we go to a club?
It's Linda's hen night. She chooses where we go.
Why did you choose here?
God, sign on to feed this place.
There's a band on at the disco though, isn't there? She said she wanted to dance to live music and not just to DJs.
I hate bands. Not half as good as the DJs. What have they got a band on for?
They're trying to bring some life back to this place.
It's dying, this place is.
It's dead.
Well, they'd want to do more than just stick a band on after the disco if they wanted this place to come alive again.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Bums up!
Everything else around here, Carol. The life is just draining away from the place, and no one ever does anything about it. Like round our way. Do you know what they do if a wall's falling down? They give it a coat of paint.
Well, I think we should have gone to a club.
Well, we can do that afterwards, but Linda wants to come here first.
Oh my God! Wouldn't it be awful if the fellas turned up as well?
Oh God, Maureen, don't say things like that.
If Linda saw Dave on our wedding night, that'd be it, you know?
I know, that's what I'm saying. Your marriage would be doomed to perpetual bad luck if you saw your fella the night before.
Hey, maybe that's what happened to me.
What are you doing in there anyway? Linda! Linda! Linda, are you coming out of there?
No!
Hold the door! Just hold the door! Jesus! No! See, you're not manoeuvring right. You've got to manoeuvre correctly, yeah?
I'll manoeuvre you in a minute.
What? What are you doing? I'm holding the door like you said, yeah?
We're in now, dickhead. Hold him.
Closer.
Come on, Dave. Now, Dave. Come on. Don't get sick, Dave. We're nearly there. Come on, that's it. Come on, Dave.
Come on, Dave.
Come on.
It's a toy.
We're nearly there, Dave. Don't get sick. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Going in the way.
Which one?
You know that little one? In the cloakroom. That little one looks like Beyonce.
Yeah, that's the one.
Was she giving me the eye?
It's all physics, you see. He's a dead weight. You've got to take that into account, yeah? Oh, shit! George! Yeah, I think he's all right. Oh, God.
I thought she was giving me the eye, that one.
You're forgetting him, though, can't you? You've got no chance with a spew of curry all over you. You'll stink all night like a Chinese chicken.
All right, I'll wash it off then. Come on, get him started, and then I can get me cats clean.
Oh, God.
Oh, where's Eddie? He should be here giving us a hand.
He went to the bar.
As long as he's not trying to chat up that little Beyonce one.
No way. I know what Eddie's like. He never chats up birds.
He gets one when he wants, though, yeah?
Yeah, but he doesn't chat them up. He just waits till the end of the night, sees one and says, "You! Come here." And they do, you know. But he won't waste his time chatting them up.
He'd have no chance anyway. All competition for me. See me when I get out to that floor.
As long as I got my suit on time, you don't gonna make it all be my promotion.
Hey!
Show you love you parents. Yeah, show you love you parents.
They can't take their eyes off me.
They will when they smell that spew curry all over you.
That's your fault, you get. Get us to go to the Chinese before we start drinking, instead of afterwards.
No, you're wrong there, Robbie, yeah? I said we should go to the Chinese first, because it puts a lining on your stomach.
Yeah, and it's has to put a lining all over my suit as well.
Come on,
lift him so his head's over the wall.
I didn't know, Robbie. I didn't know he'd start drinking Jager bombs. And he'd been on double solar comfort before that, you know? I said to him, that's a lethal combination, Dave, yeah?
Come on,
lift him. And keep him over that side. If he gets my other leg, I'm done for.
1, 2, 3, lift! You want to stick your fingers down your throat, Dave?
You want to stick your fingers down your throat? And keep them there. Give us all a rest.
I'm only telling him, Robbie, because he's not going to have much of a stag night if he spins it all in there, is he?
Hey, it's a good job his bird can't see you now, isn't it?
She just laughed, or she's mental.
She's all right, though, isn't she? She's a good laugh, isn't it?
She drinks as much as him, you know. Well, I was going out with this cracking board once. Nice, good-looking girl she was. We went down to the foursome with Dave and his board. I got the first round in and asked them what they were having. The girl I'm with says, a cosmopolitan. For girls drink, you know? Know what Dave's board asked for?
What?
A pint of Guinness.
No way!
I swear, she wasn't joking. I'm out with this nice girl for the first time, and Dave's board is acting like a docker.
She's a laugh though, isn't she?
Laugh? The one I was with, she never went out with me again after that. I said to Dave after, fancy letting her board behave like that.
She's always the same, he said. She'll settle down when she's married. I wouldn't take the chance.
They're all the same though, Robbie. Women, you can't get a laugh out of them once they turn 30.
I know I'll make it all feel right, oh yeah.
What are you doing, Calf?
Just my name.
Hey, that's Whopper. I didn't know you could do that, Calf. It's good, that, isn't it?
He's a good artist, Calvis.
Hey, don't cross it out. It was crap. I thought it was deadly. Useless. You should have seen the stuff I did in the check-in. What was it like, Mark?
Didn't you see that, really? Oh, it's deadly, that was. He did a big drawing, didn't you, Cav? On the back of a jack star. Covered the whole door.
Took me weeks to do that, you know. Every time we went to the check-in, I spent longer in the jacks than I did on the dance floor.
It was like abstract, wasn't it? Not like that stupid abstract stuff. You could see pictures in it, couldn't you, Cav?
Even Eddie said that was good, didn't he? Yeah. But then, we went in there 1 week, and they had the painters in to paint out all the writing in the jacks. They stippled over my picture with Artex and put up a sign saying they'd prosecute anyone found defacing the place. Didn't they, Robin?
Yeah.
How'd you draw like that?
I don't know. It's fairly easy. I wish I could draw like that.
Don't you, Robbie?
Too right. I'd spend all day drawing my own porny pictures.
Oh, I can do them. Give some jaw, Cat.
Look at that. It's going to take ages to join.
There's no rush anyway. We can't just leave Dave here, can we?
Your bike. He'll be all right. We can keep nipping in here and have a look at him. Where's Eddie? He should be here. Dave's his best mate.
Eddie doesn't like it when he gets pissed.
It writes with gold.
Eddie never gets himself legless, though, does he? It's because he's captain of the team. He thinks he should set an example. He's dead professional, Eddie. And he's dead serious about his football. He's dead serious about everything.
It's only Sunday late, though, isn't it? I mean, it's not professional football, is it?
Don't let Eddie lose it.
Does that look all right or what?
It's a... You'll never get that off properly. You need petrol, yeah?
I'll tell you what. Why don't you piss off to the garage and get a can?
No, what? Listen. If there were still petrol lighters, you'd be okay, wouldn't you? It's all gas, though, now, isn't it? See, that's an example of where technology has made significant advances and losses at the same time.
Yeah, that's just what I was thinking.
You know what? I read about it, yeah? See, if there were still petrol lighters, you'd be able to take the cotton wool out and clean your cats with it, wouldn't you, yeah? You wouldn't be stinking of curry then.
Yeah, I'd just be stinking of freaking petrol, wouldn't I?
No! It would evaporate, yeah?
I wish you wouldn't evaporate. Oh, what the fuck is that?
It's a young one with no clothes on.
It's got no arms or legs.
I know. And where's her head?
I don't do heads. I only do the important bits. I'm a primitive.
You're a fucking idiot. You give her three tits.
Where?
There.
That's her stomach. Tell them why's it got a nipple on it. That's not a nipple, that's a belly button.
Anyway, you gobshite. Who told you heads weren't important? The way a board looks, her face and that, it's dead important. It's more bad than a beautiful girl.
They're all the same when you get down to it though, aren't they, Robbie?
Get lost. When you get married, you just spend longer looking at it than you screwing them, don't you? I tell you, when you get married, she'd be a crack on my missus as well. Beautiful.
She might be a cracker when you get married to her, Robbie. But she won't stay that way.
She bleeding well.
Really, Robbie? You know what the young ones around here are like. Before you get married, they look great, some of them. But once they've got you, they start letting themselves go. After 2 years and a couple of kids, what happens? They start leaving the makeup off and putting on weight. Before you know where you are, the cracker you've married has turned into a monster.
My missus won't be like that. If any board of mine starts acting slummy, she gets booed out on her arse. A woman has a responsibility to a fella. No board of mine's gonna turn fat.
I like a bit of weight. Something to get a hold of. Hey Eddie! Hey Eddie! What's up? What's the talent like out there?
I don't know about the talent. The beer is shite.
You wanna know why that is, Eddie? It's because it's pumped up with top pressure.
Is that right?
Yeah, I'm a real ale man, I am.
Whose smart idea was it to come here anyway? We could have stayed at the pub.
There's no talent in the pub, eh?
The campaign for real ale. I support that. I've got a badge.
What am I going to do? That little Beyonce one's going to be all over me in half an hour. What's she going to say if she can smell curry everywhere?
Tell her it's the latest aftershave.
But dross for men.
Yeah, but dross for men. Even angels will fall.
Yeah, but instead of getting your oats, you get chicken biryani.
No danger. I'm in there like swimwear. Did you say it to me the other?
Yeah, it was me who told you.
Women. Tarts.
He's always on about tarts, isn't he? Yeah,
you know what your problem is, Bobby? You were born with your brain between your legs.
That's not a problem.
Isn't it?
What's wrong with liking women, Eddie?
Look at him. You're lined up like him, Robbie. See him? He's the best striker I've ever seen. But it's all over for him. Well, it will be after tomorrow.
Christ, Eddie. He's getting married. He's not having his legs sawn off.
You just watch him over the next few months. I've seen it before. Once they get married, the edge goes. Before long, they start missing the odd game. Not turning up. You mark my words. The next thing is they stop playing altogether. They have to take the kids out on a Sunday. Or they go down to the pub at dinner time drinking. Or they just can't get out of bed because they've been on the nest all night. Nah, it's the beginning of the end for him.
I'm never going to get married, Eddie. I'm staying at home with me mum. Don't you think that woman's suffering enough? I'll still be there playing defence when I turn 40, Eddie. I keep myself fit, I do.
I know you do, but you're not like Robbie, are you? Robbie's a tarts man.
Give it a rest, will you, Eddie? Sunday league football isn't the be all and end all, is it? This is supposed to be a stag night, not a pre-match pep talk.
Who the fuck are you talking to? I'll remember that, Robbie. I'll remember that when I'm picking this week's team.
Are you dropping him, Eddie?
Are you, Eddie?
I don't care.
Don't you? Not even when there's a Premier League stag going to be there on Sunday.
And you're meaning, on Sunday, I'm at the top of my form, Eddie, yeah? A Premier League scout, Eddie.
There's talent scouts from England, combing this country looking for potential.
But we'll be without Dave. Dave won't be playing on Sunday, will he?
That's his hard luck, isn't it? If he wants to be in Spain and we've got a scout watching us, that's his hard luck.
Come on, let's get out there. Listen to a few tunes. It's great when the music's playing. Come on, have a few jars and all that. Look, Eddie, I'm already set up with this good-looking young one. Just like Beyonce. Isn't she, Kat? I'll have the little Beyonce one, and you take her me.
What? Spend all night chatting up some dumb tart? 2 hours of suffering her talking and drinking and dancing just to get a poke at her? Piss off.
I'll take her maid for you, Robbie.
You're a bleeding liability.
Well, you always go for the best looking young ones in the place. I get nervous with that type.
I've told you, haven't I? Always go for the crackers. Loads of fellas make that mistake. They see a good looking board and think they've got no chance. But it's the opposite. If a board looks really good, and you can see she spent hours getting herself to look something special, it's because she wants someone to cop off with her.
But it just gets shy, Robbie. Come on, me and you it is. But listen, no standing at the side of the floor all night. When I say go in, we go in, right?
All right. Come on.
Hey, hold on. Where are you going?
What, Eddie?
What about him?
What about?
Just going to leave him here, are you? He's our mate, isn't he?
Of course he is, Eddie.
Yeah.
And you're just going to leave him here, are you? You're going to leave him here like this while you go off listening to cheap music and chasing tarts.
Ah, hey, Eddie.
Ah, hey, what? You're just going to fuck off on your mate when he's incapable. Needs looking after.
He'll be all right, Eddie.
That's loyalty for you, isn't it?
Well, you look after him, Eddie. We've had our time. Christ, we got him in here, didn't we? Look, skewed curry all over my best suit.
Haven't you heard of loyalty? Go on, piss off. I'll look after him. I'm staying in the bar. I'll keep nipping in to see that he's alright. Go on, piss off. It's shite out there anyway. All it is music. Fucking music.
I like music, Eddie.
You would, wouldn't you? Because you're fucking soft like them.
What's wrong with music, Eddie?
You know what music does, don't you?
Makes you feel good, Eddie.
Makes you feel good. Makes you go soft.
Come on, Eddie. Come with us. Dave will be alright.
There's a band on afterwards, Eddie.
Is there? I bet they're shite as well.
They're not a local band, Eddie. They're over from London. They'd be good.
They didn't look like Londoners to me. I just saw them coming in. They looked local. I thought I recognised one of them.
Nah. That'll be off the telly, Eddie. A big league this lot, honest.
What do you want me to do, Robbie? Rush off home from the autograph book?
I'm going. Come on.
Hey, are you coming with us for a dance?
Nah, it's a stag night, isn't it? You know what fellas are supposed to do in a stag night, don't you?
What?
Get pissed!
I get knocked down! I let go of the cage! You never go to keep me down! I get knocked down!
Linda! Linda, are you coming out?
No!
Linda! Linda, love, why not?
Because, Bernie, love, you're getting right up my fucking nose.
Linda, do you really think that's appropriate language for a bride to be?
Take no notice of her, Karen. They all go a bit funny before they get married. She's probably just having a little cry to herself. They do that the night before.
Ah, yeah.
Ah. What? She's having a little cry.
Oh, did you, Bernie? Did you cry the night before you were married?
No. Just been crying ever since.
Frankie, leave her. She's just having a little cry to herself.
Crying?
What for?
Frances, she's crying for what she'll be losing tomorrow.
Oh, Maury.
She lost that years ago.
Just like the rest of us.
No, I don't mean that. But you do give up something when you get married, don't you? You give up being a girl when you get married.
What'd you turn into instead?
A fella? Her Dave's not going to be too happy about that tomorrow night, is he?
emotional.
I mean, pictures and romance are great and all that, but you can't really do anything with them, can you? Apart from looking at them. What have you got them then, Mo?
A pair of barbecue chairs in sallow brown.
What are they? Barbecue chairs. You know, for in the summer when you have your friends round for a barbecue.
Oh, they'll be very functional, Maury. They'll have a great time at the barbecue in a block of flats 6 floors high.
Oh, but they will have a balcony, won't they? No, I don't mean they'll be able to have a barbecue on the balcony, but they'll be able to sit out there, won't they?
And watch the sun go down on the other blocks of flats.
I'll tell her they're balcony chairs. She won't know the difference, will she? I'll tell her they're balcony chairs.
We all club together at work. We got them a coffee percolator.
Ooh.
You know, for real coffee.
That'll be nice, Carol. They'll be able to sit and have coffee
when their friends come round.
Or when they're sitting out in the balcony. What's getting burning? Well, my fella knows someone at work who makes antique furniture. They're great. We got them a coffee table in antique. Oh, Christ. I hope they like coffee. I've got them a coffee set.
Oh, that'll be really swish, won't it?
They will like coffee, Frances. You might drink tea when you're home with your mum, but when you become a couple, you drink coffee together. And that worked out lovely, hasn't it? Just think, they'll be able to sit at Bernadette's coffee table, drinking coffee out of Carol's percolator, in the coffee cups you gave them, sitting on my balcony chairs. Oh, it'll remind them of us, won't it?
They'll never be able to forget us, Mo.
Linda!
Oh, come on, Linda, love.
All the good-looking lads will have gone home if they think I'm not here.
The bitch! The stuck up! She was really fucking humbly. She was destroyed when you got in close. All right there, Dave, yeah?
I've told you 3 times, haven't I? What do you want me to do? Write it out for you?
But I couldn't hear you in there with the music. Go on, what did she say?
She said, I never dance at men in suits.
Is that what she said?
I thought she was making a joke at first, you know, coming on with the laughs and that. I give her a big smile and said to her, I'll tell you what, if you don't like suits, why don't we go back to yours and you can take it off for me.
Did you? What did she say?
She walked away. She walked away from me. What's wrong with suits? Cost 65 quid this did. From suits you. No rubbish goes on my back. The stuck up cow. She didn't look like Beyonce, I mean. She looks more like Jay-Z. I told her though, you don't want to hear me, will you? Classic it was. In a low voice said, I don't waste my time on hero bikes and don't appreciate quality.
Is that what you said, Robbie?
Too right. This suit, I said, cost every cent of 65 notes. Just see her face. See her face when I told her that.
Yeah, Robbie. And she said you were robbed.
I thought you said you couldn't hear.
I couldn't hear what you said, but I could hear what she said.
Well, you want to get your freaking ears tested, because she never said that.
She did, Robbie. I was standing right beside her.
All right, Eddie. I'm just keeping an eye on David.
Good lad.
Doing you a favour.
Yeah, Cal's doing the same for you out there.
What?
You know that tard who gave you the elbow, the really good looking one? Cav's dancing with her. She's all over him as well.
I don't care. I wasn't interested anyway. She was destroyed. Oh, come on.
Go on then. Go on, piss off to your dancing and your music. Bleeding. Music makes you want to spew. Hey, Dave. Is that what made you spew? The music?
Hey baby, think I wanna marry you.
Music.
But if we do not change, tomorrow has no place for us.
What? Oh,
it says on the door in there.
There must have been a student's dance on here. No one would censor or something like that.
They write stupid things, don't they?
Students. I went to a dance once, you know. At the students, you know what I mean?
You should have seen the toilets in there. They were full of writing. And it was crap. You couldn't understand any of it. Seriously.
What was it like?
You know, these stupid things. There was this thing about God being a woman.
Oh, you know, it was terrible.
And then there was this thing that said, a woman needs a fish like a fella needs a bike.
What?
You know, really stupid things.
And the bloody taxes my fella pays to keep them students. You think with all them brains they'd write something sensible on the toilet wall?
Take no notice of a bird.
There were some really good things. There was this great thing it said, love is blind, marriage is an institution. Who wants to live in an institution for the blind? God, Francis! That's wicked! Don't say things like that!
Oh, come on. Let's go.
You haven't done your makeup.
I can't be bothered. Come on.
You're not going into the dance without your makeup on.
Why not?
Come on, Linda. Do your makeup. We'll wait for you. You don't want to look a mess. Come on, I'll do it for you. Be quicker then.
Oh, go on. Go on, you'll not wait long enough. I'll do it myself. I'll follow you then. Linda, we're your mates, aren't we? It's your hen night. You don't think we deserve it, do you? You're not deserving. I'll come find you when I'm ready.
Linda, we stick with you. We only go out when we're all ready.
Why don't just come on me honeymoon?
Well, we would, Linda, love, but I'm afraid if I was there, you wouldn't get a look in.
Look, I'm a big girl now. I can find my way out to the ladies and into the dance.
Linda, it's your hens. We stick with you.
Yeah, until some fella comes along. Then you'll be gone like a flash.
Well, you've got to get a bit of fresh air, don't you?
Is that what you call it?
With some of them, that's what it feels like.
Well, you better work yourself tonight, Bernie. You're going to have a competition.
From who?
Well, you don't think I'm going to have my hen light sit at the bar like some old married woman, do you? Oh, no. I'm gonna get out on that floor and get real legless. If it's the last blink, well, that's what I'll make it.
Well, you better get a move on, or your last fling will be already flung. Come on, let me do it. Go on, you lot, go. You can be getting the drinks in.
But what you have?
Get us a sport in them. And what do you want, Linda?
Get us a pint of Guinness.
No, no, come on, Linda. Enough is enough. We've seen you doing this before, and we all think it's a great laugh, but not tonight. You're on a hen's, not a stag's. Now, come on. Something a bit more ladylike.
Alright, get me a pint of cider.
Oh, piss off!
You have the best of the beach, Lindsay. You like them?
Alright, with a little cherry on top.
Oh, lovely!
Come on, we'll be in the bar.
We just have a drink and listen to the tunes until you come out.
Ooh, give me some music. Music, music, music. It's an aphrodisiac to me.
Valium is an aphrodisiac to you.
Too right, come on, girls. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Yeah, hurry. It's great the way music gets to you, though, isn't it? You can come into a disco or a dance and be feeling really down, but once you walk into the music, it gives you a lift, doesn't it? Makes you feel special.
Yeah. I get lost in the music, I do.
Yeah, I do that.
It's like I become someone else when the music is playing.
Yeah, I'm like that.
Oh, you know, if it wasn't for music, I wouldn't be getting married tomorrow.
Don't be stupid, Linda. You're not sometimes. You are, you know.
I'm not being stupid. We were dancing when he asked me to marry him.
When a man loves a woman.
And all I heard was this voice in my ear. Like it was part of the music saying, will you marry me? And I said, yeah. I would have said, yeah, if I was dancing with Dracula's ugly brother.
Don't be daft, Linda.
When the music was over, I looked up and there was Dave beaming down on me, talking about getting married. And I'm wondering, what is he on about? And then I remembered. And the next thing you know, here I am tonight.
Linda.
Oh, come on, hurry up and get my hair done. I'm dying to go and have a dance. There might be another opportunity after tonight.
Linda, you're getting married, not getting locked up.
There you go. You do get frightened, you know. I mean, if it was just marrying Dave, it'd be alright. He's okay, Dave is. But honest, it's like I'm getting married to a town.
To a what?
It's not just like I'm marrying Dave. It's like if I marry him, I marry everything else. I could sit down and draw you a chart of everything that'll happen in my life after tomorrow.
Do you know something, Linda? You're my best mate. But half the time, I think you're a loony.
Oh, yeah! Linda, don't mess your hair up! Oh, come on. Well, look at it this way.
Jesus, you wouldn't hear if a bomb went off, would you? It's your own fault. You can't blame me. See, it's all your own fault. See, you don't have to drink, do you? You don't have to do anything. The premiership, Dave. And you could have been coming with me. You should have been coming with me. Not with a wife, though. A wag. You can't travel when there's too much baggage weighing you down. She's okay, your bird. She's all right, but... But round here, Dave, once you get married, you're trapped then. It's the end. You're never going to go at all. You're just going to stay forever in this fucking dying dump. It's hard to get out anyway, Dave. You know it is. Look at all the scouts who've seen our team. But I'm still here, aren't I? It's hard to go, but once you get married, you're never going to go at all. You've got to fucking leave yourself free, Dave, so that when the time comes, you can be off without a word to anyone. You've got to fucking leave yourself free like me. I can go anywhere, Dave. Anywhere, at any time. There's nothing holding me down. But if you don't want to come with me, if you want to get married to some tart while you do it, yeah, you do it. Dave! Eden!
What are we coming here for? We told him we'd see them in the bar, yeah?
Yeah, you silly box. We told him that because we wanted to get rid of them, didn't we?
Did we? Mine was nice.
Nice. You'd want to see her, eh? She could have had the star, heart, and jaws.
Where's Pat?
We saw him way up the back with the one who looks like Beyonce.
I hope he gets a dose.
I got in the bar. Idiots.
Are you pissed, Eddie?
Have you ever seen me pissed?
No, Eddie.
No, Eddie.
I don't get pissed. I'm not like you. I'm not like him. I don't get pissed.
No, Eddie. What a minute.
Shut up, silly.
Yeah, shut it, soft arse. Look after Dave. I'm going to the bar. Oh, yeah!
I think he is in a piss, you know, Robbie.
Well, there's no need to go tell him, is there? Eddie thinks he never gets pissed. I've seen him in the state loads of times, but I never tell him.
Well, why doesn't he just say, you know, that he's pissed?
I don't know, do I? He just likes to pretend. You go along. It's like he pretends one day he's going to play big league football. You just go along with
it. I'm sorry, Robbie.
What about Kath? What's up, son?
You know.
What? What?
I'm sorry about getting off with your little Beyonce one. It wasn't my fault.
Did you get off her? Oh, Christ, you didn't, did you? Did you hear that, Billy?
What? What's wrong?
Ah, no. You'll be alright, though. You didn't go outside on it, did you?
Yeah, around the back, why?
Yeah, well, you didn't give her one, did you?
Yeah, she couldn't get out there fast enough.
Oh, Cav. Cav.
What?
Come on, Cav. Why do you think I gave her the knockback?
What?
Tommy Stevens told me, didn't he? The one who looks like Beyonce's got the clap.
The clap?
Clap.
Fuck off.
Tommy Stevens doesn't lie.
For fuck's sake.
I know. The clap. Come on, Billy. Those other two will be back with the bar now. I want to see these two have copped off a calf. Stunners. What are they like, Billy?
You want to see them calf. Ugliest boots you've ever seen.
Oh, go away, you idiot! Don't mind him, he's blind. That's it, Dave, go on, get it up!
Don't you think better get him sobered up. It's his stag leg, isn't it?
Christ! You consider it all of a sudden, aren't you? I try and think about him when you're around the back getting the dogs off that board.
I haven't got a dose. You were just messing.
You wait and see, pal. You wait.
Go away. Come on. Let's try and make him get it all up.
Lee, Christ, it's not a proper stag night if the groom's conscious.
It's bad luck if the groom's sober the night before he gets married, yeah?
It's true, lad. Me dad told me he was sober on his stag night, and look what happened to him the next day.
What?
He married me mother. Right, get himself heads over the ball and he'll be okay.
Listen, dear, the souls are sick. How's your tongue held these days? I know you're scared, it won't be the same. I promise you, I'll always remain. That's the need to see my side.
I cracked again. Every fuck. Every socket in this place is a fucking antique.
What a bleeding
pump. I mean, every socket I try just blows.
Well, keep trying.
Yeah, well, I'll keep trying, mate. But I'm telling you, it'll be a bloody miracle if you get on tonight. I mean, what a place. What a fucking town.
Hey, dickhead. I'll have you know you're talking about my hometown.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I can see why you left it now. Where you going? Is it Jack's?
There's no Jack's walking backstage.
For fuck's sake! You see what I mean?
Bloody fucking
well,
when he turns over.
I get lost. You'd be moaning about the state of the blood sockets if you were playing the Green Hollywood Bowl.
Yeah? Well, I'll tell you something, Pete, mate. After this place, I'll never complain about another plug socket again.
Well, coming here's done some good then. Wait. Get me acoustic out of the van, just in case.
The acoustic? Not they want
to. Oh, will you just get it?
You're a boss. Boss.
Yeah.
Sick at missing you.
Maybe that's the best thing for him.
Still kept her sense of humour. Great. I can't believe it.
Are you doing fine in a dump like this?
It's work, isn't it? Look and see us, lads.
Wait! Give me a piece of paper. Where's a piece of paper?
Hey, you're on the telly and radio now, aren't you?
Now and then.
What are you doing playing in the dive like this?
It's only one gig. Anyway, it was arranged before the single happened.
Oh, well, you should have told them to fuck off. You can't be belittling yourselves by playing in dives like this when you're famous. Living in London now, do you?
Yeah.
What's it like?
It's alright, man. It's okay.
Oh, yeah, it's fucking great.
It's okay.
Jesus.
Small world, what?
I'm sorry about the paper. I couldn't
oh,
find it either.
Oh, man, you don't want me to do this.
What, two calf and old mate.
For Christ's sake, man, you really don't want to make me do this.
You're joking, aren't you? Of course I do. Oh,
man, I used to live just down the road from you.
I know. I'm going to show that to people.
Hey, is it true what they say about the boards? You know, the groupies.
A bit of it. Most of it's fiction.
Oh, I bet it's not. Jesus, I bet you can have anything you want, can't you?
Look at that. To Billy.
Hey, what sort of car do you drive now?
I haven't got one. Listen, what are you lads all up to these days?
Oh, fuck all us. Got a big house in London, have you?
Flat. What, you sound at Dublin?
No, we work.
Got a big house in the country then, have you?
What sort of work's that on?
Listen, Peter. We don't want to talk about us. It's boring. We just fucking work. Go on. Tell us all about you. Tell us all about the band and what it's like and all about it.
Back away. What do you want to be hearing about me for?
Peter, you're someone who's made it. We're proud of you. We are.
Who is he? Can't you read?
Look, lads, I've got to go. You haven't even got the gear set up yet. Gotta chill up on that, you know?
Aren't you gonna come and have a pint with us?
I'm not even set up yet.
What about afterwards, you know? After the gig?
Gig.
Yeah, maybe. It's a possibility. Look, I'll see you, lads. And look after the Southern Comfort King, won't you?
See you, Peter!
See you later!
Hey! That was Peter Taylor! Oh! He's famous, yeah?
A superstar will have no fear. The camera's here.
Imagine coming back to a dive like this when you're as big as he is. See his boots? Class, weren't they?
I'm going to get a pair of them.
Why won't they? They just won't.
They'll be custom made anyway.
You get nothing like that around here.
Christ. The way he must live.
Oh, his boards never grow old, do they?
Boots like that would suit me. I'll bet he's never bored. And he used to live near us. Hey, guess what?
I know. Dave's bird's out there.
What?
I've just seen her now. She's out there dancing.
Go for a drink, are we? I said, hey, listen, You better run along. Snow White will be looking for you.
You didn't get it though. I said, oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were one of the seven dwarfs.
You start laughing then, not knowing he's got a sense of humour. Oh yeah, he says, I'm dozy. I says, you're not bleeding, kid. I'm walking away and he's shouting after me. Oh, I'm going to the bar, I'll be in the bar, yeah?
I says, yeah. And that's the best place for you, along with every other pint that thinks he's a quart.
Custom made, yeah? Go on in. Guess.
Guess who?
I don't fucking know, do I?
Peter Taylor.
Who?
You know Peter Taylor. Remember? He used to live around our way. Played the guitar. He's with this band that's on tonight. He's famous, eh?
Famous?
I'm going to get a pair of little boots, Eddie, yeah? You'll be able to see him afterwards, Eddie. He's going to have a drink with us, you know? After the gig.
After the what?
The gig! That's what they call it when they play somewhere. He's a real star, you know, Eddie.
I thought I told you to look after Dave.
We have done, Eddie.
You all right, Dave? Are you okay?
All right there, Dave, yeah? He's fantastic, Eddie. Not stuck up or anything, you know? Look, Eddie. See what it says, Eddie? To Cav, an old mate. And that's his name there.
He did one for me, Eddie, look. I'll bet he'll do one for you if you ask him.
What are these?
I know. It's real hard to make out of first. I couldn't make it out of first, but look.
This? What is this?
We didn't have an autograph book, Eddie.
You big, soft, tarts.
What?
Kids get autographs. Are you little kids?
No, Eddie, but he's famous.
Famous? Famous?
Hey, what are you doing?
What am I doing?
You've just flushed Dave's head, Eddie.
Do it again, it might sober him up.
Hey, that was my autograph. And mine.
Yeah?
Yeah, but you couldn't read it anyway. Hey, that was my fucking autograph.
Who the fuck do you think you're talking to? You don't get autographs from people like him. He's just a fucking nobody. You don't want to waste your time, Cav. See, it's people like you running around after people like him that make them what they are. You're as good as he is. Did he ask you for your autograph? Did he?
No.
No. You want to keep your dignity, dude. You're as good as he is. You could do what he does if you wanted to. You can do anything he can do. We all can. We can do anything we want to do. Anything. He's nothing special. So don't belittle yourself begging for a scrawling on a piece of bog paper. We can all write our names, you know. Here, give me some of that chalk. Give it me. Look, it's dead easy, you see? You want an autograph? I'll give you a fucking autograph. Here.
Give us a go, Eddie. I'm gonna do my autograph, I am. I'm gonna do mine bigger than yours, yeah?
It was great meeting him though, wasn't it, Robbie?
It was all right. You should have seen the boots he had on, Eddie. You know, women's boots.
He's not big for big shots. He hasn't even got a car. He's nothing special. Anyone could do what he does.
Oh yeah, anyone could do it. That's why later on, whilst he's up on that stage, with all the coloured spotlights on him, you'll be down on the floor, dancing in the dark, with all the other nobodies.
Here's that. Go on.
What?
Put your name up.
I don't want to, Eddie.
Why?
There's no point, is there?
The point, Cav, is that our names are up there. Where's yours?
What?
Your name has got to be up there.
Why?
So they can be seen, that's why. So that everyone will know that we've been here.
They only paint it out, they always do.
So we'll come back and do it again.
Then they'll stipple over the walls, so you can't see anything on them.
So we'll come back and carve our names out, won't we? I've told you, Cav, we can do anything. Write your name.
Go on, Cav. I wouldn't mind, but he can write better than any of us.
Come on, Cav. I want you to do it for me. You know the way you do it in fancy scrolls and that? That's clever, that is, Cav. You do it for us. Come on.
All right, Eddie.
Ah, good lad, Cav.
Who taught you not to write? What could you say of that?
You show us how it should be done, Cav.
Get off me! Go on, use that goal. It'll take a bit of time, this. Go on!
What about Dave?
I can keep the eye on Dave, Eddie.
Come on.
You going for a dance, Eddie?
No way.
Why not, Eddie?
Party back is in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time.
Because I'd rather watch you make fools of yourself.
Oh, you're very funny. Oh, smack that!
Body rockers in the house tonight.
We just can't take the risk. For Linda's sake,
God, I know. I'm not saying we should take the risk, Bernie.
If she sees her Dave tonight, that's it, you know. Her marriage has had it. We'll go somewhere else. We'll have to. My mum knew a couple who saw each other the night before they got married. And you know what happened?
What?
The next day in church, they were standing in the archway having their picture taken. And the archway collapsed on them. Killed outright.
And that's true. That was in the paper, wasn't it?
Yeah. The picture was in the paper, Bernie. Just a pile of stones.
There was this woman near us. She got an emerald engagement ring.
Good way.
Did she take it off for the wedding?
You should never wear green for a wedding, should you?
I know. Everyone told her. But she wouldn't listen. Thought she knew best. That type, you know. Thought she would make her own rules.
You can't, can you?
She wouldn't learn, though. A couple of years later, she got married again.
And do you know what colour her dress was? Green?
No. Everyone told her. Her mother was distraught. But she wouldn't listen. Tried to make out things like that didn't matter.
But what happened, Bernie?
3 months married, and poor fella had a cardiac arrest. Gone. Finished.
I bet she was sorry after that.
No, that's not the end of it. She got married again.
God, you wouldn't think a fella would take a chance on her.
She was told, time and time again she was told. Everyone told her. And she said, all right, no green this time.
Oh, thank God for that. And did they live happily in that?
Yeah, for about 10 minutes. As she was walking out of the church, she slipped, hit her head on a gravestone, dead.
But there was no green, Bernie.
No, there was no green, Mum. But as they picked her up, what did they see pinned to her dress?
What?
An opal brooch.
God, when you think about it, getting married's a terrible liability, isn't it?
You should never wear an opal, unless it's your birthstone.
She was asking for trouble, wasn't she, Bernie?
She wouldn't learn, though, you know? Tried to make out till she could just make up her own rules.
Smack that all on the floor. Smack that into some more. Smack that till you get so smacked down.
Oh, for Christ's sake, what's wrong with you?
If he's wanting to talk, he's going to come out. Come on. Want to get back out to the dancing?
Linda, we've got to go somewhere else.
What's wrong with her? Give her shop rope room tickets. I'll go and get the coats. Make sure it's all clear. What's wrong?
Nothing. Apart from the fact the man you're marrying is here tonight.
Who, Dave?
Where?
He's here. Somewhere we've seen all his mates. Right. So?
So what?
So why do we have to leave?
Linda, you cannot see your future husband on the eve of your wedding.
Says who? Linda, you see your Dave tonight and your marriage is doomed.
Oh, get lost, Carol, will you?
Linda, do you want to end up under a pile of stones?
We don't want to leave, Linda. We're doing this for you. This is for your sake.
You can't afford to see Dave tonight, Linda. You don't believe that, do you?
You've got to believe it, Linda, because it's true.
You do? You really believe it, don't you?
Yeah, and so should you. Now come on, give me your coat room ticket and I'll go get the coat.
You don't believe this, do you?
You don't see each other the night before you get married.
Oh, get lost, come on.
Linda, we don't want to see you put your future in jeopardy.
If it wasn't for the fact that you lot are my mates and have been for a very long time, I'd say it's all off your trolley. Why don't you do what you want to do? Why don't you do what you think you should do? But you won't, will you? That's the biggest sin of the lot of yous, isn't it? Yous will just keep doing what yous are told to do, won't yous?
Nobody tells me what to do, Linda. I do what I want to do.
Oh, do you, Bernie? Well, look, you came here tonight to get off with a fella, and there's loads of them out there, so come on. Come on out and get one.
I could do, Linda. I could, but for your sake...
For my sake? Just forget about my sake, right? Now, come on, all of yous. Oh, feck off, then.
Well, if you ask me, I say she hasn't been herself all night.
But that's what she's like, Bernie.
She can be like this, you know. It's the pressure, isn't it? I know what's going through her mind.
Yeah, but if she's acting like this now, Bernie, imagine what she'd be like tomorrow.
What we've got to do is stop her doing anything stupid, whether she wants to or not.
I say we go and see the fellas. Tell them to go somewhere else.
But they won't, though, will they? You know what fellas are like.
We were here first, though, weren't we?
Feck it. I'll go and see if I can find Eddie. He'll tell them what to do. If he says leave, they'll go.
Okay.
Francis. Frankie.
What?
Oh, forget about it. Listen, Linda. I don't know what's wrong with you tonight, but you can't half be an awkward bitch.
They want to dance in here, yeah? They want to listen to the single with Chart Poppers.
Hiya!
Well,
hello,
Bob. How are you doing, eh?
Excuse me. Hiya!
Christ! Hey! Oh, Jesus, come here!
Fuck's sake. Chart Poppers.
State you.
What do you mean?
Hey, and don't be long, yeah? You're on then.
I thought you said you couldn't get any power.
Yeah, well. I will now.
Where did you get your boots?
Just a little place on Oxford Street.
They're green.
Did you know we were on?
No. Are you in this lot long?
About a year. Are you just out for a dance, are you?
Sort of.
Oh, Christ. I thought you'd have given up coming to this sort of place.
The same could be said for you.
No, it's different for me, isn't it? I'll never grow up. Anyway, it's work, isn't it? I don't come out of choice. How are you?
I'm alright, how are you?
I'm great. I'm alright.
The stadium?
I thought you'd like it.
I do, but you can't be seen coming around here dressed like that. You'd be locked up.
I know. We went across the road for a pint before. You should have heard them in there. Alright, cowboy! Where's Tonto then? Idiots.
Well, what do you expect if you come around in women's boots?
Oh, could you?
I
you know better than that.
You left my hair, I swear to God.
I can't believe it. It's great to see you.
It's great to see you too. I suppose.
I suppose? Oh, well, I just fell off and tune up then.
No, wait. Do you remember that song that you used to sing from?
Which one?
The Oasis.
Oh, Wonderwall.
Yeah, will you sing it for me?
I'll be guitarist back.
Come on, for old time's sake.
Yeah, Marie. You gonna help me out with the words?
Yeah.
Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. And I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads that lead you there are winding. And all the lights that light the way you're blinding. There are many things that I like to say to you, but I don't know how. Cause maybe,
maybe
you're gonna be the one that saves me.
Saves me.
And after all,
you're my one.
Stop doing properly. Cause maybe,
maybe
you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall.
Linda! Hiya.
What's her name? What's her name? Your mate?
Francis.
Francis, yeah. How is she?
She's alright, look.
Hold on a second. Fancy a dance?
For you?
No, with Tonto. Who do you think?
I didn't think fellas from famous bands went dancing. I'd always kept yourself away from the rabble.
Oh, they do usually, but you're special rabble.
Such flattery. Or is it an insult?
Come on, what's the dance up here these days? Still do big fish, little fish.
No, it's the foxtrot actually.
Oh, is it actually?
I got feeling. Woo!
Francis, did you find the fellas?
What did they say?
Well, are they going, Fran?
No.
Fellas.
Listen, guess whose band is playing tonight?
What?
Peter Taylor. It's his band.
We don't care what band is playing, Francis. We want to know
Bernie. The thing is, Bernie, in his band is a fella called Peter Taylor. And him and Linda only had a thing going for about 2 years.
Say what?
They were both outside the door. Just now, arms around each other. He was singing to her. Oh my God. So that's why she wanted to come here.
Well, we don't know that, Brenda.
Come off it, Francis.
Look, Francis, if she was with him for that long, she's bound to know what band he's playing in.
There's a poster outside, isn't there?
I wondered why she wanted to come to a dump like this. But fancy doing something like that in your wedding night.
No good will come of this, I'm telling you, I know.
Look, she's only talking to him.
Yeah, and we all know we're talking, Liz.
Don't, Bernie, don't!
You don't see your ex-fella the night before you're getting married.
Look, she just bumped into him. Well, we can soon see, can't we? I'll get her in here.
Oh, Christ. I knew we should have gone to check in. I knew we shouldn't have come here.
Where did you say she was?
Just outside.
Well, she's not there now.
But where is she?
How do I know? But I tell you one thing. She's up to no good. That girl is playing with fire. Look, we're her mates. We need to sort out a way to stop her getting burned.
Oh, God.
Oh, for God's sake, Maureen, shut up, will you?
Oh, why can't everything just be nice?
Who said everything won't be nice, Maureen?
No good will come in this. You mark my words, you'll see.
We'll sort it out, Maureen. Don't worry. There's going to be a wedding tomorrow. There'll be a nice cake. And a nice service, nice
bridesmaids,
and a nice bride and groom. But Mo, we've just got to make sure Linda doesn't do anything stupid, that's all. We're her mates. What are mates for, huh? Yeah. Come on, everything will be all right, love. You'll see, we look after. Everything will be very, very nice. Come on, Karen! Come on, girl!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hi, Robbie.
All right, Carol, isn't it?
You're good with names, aren't you?
Good at most things, Carol.
Good to go, Robbie.
Okay.
See you tomorrow at the wedding.
Yeah.
Sorry. Sorry.
You're in there, Robbie, yeah?
Fancy it much though.
Don't you?
Nah. That's great though. Come on, hurry up or then one or two we left in the barrel have gone. Hey, they're crackers, aren't they?
Yours is Robbie, yeah, but mine.
Dead ringer for Jennifer Lawrence, isn't she? Come on. Oh, well. Look at that.
That's a serious bit of work there, Cav, yeah? It's alright, isn't it?
Yeah. You'd want to see these two we've copped off a Cav. Mine looks like Jennifer Lawrence, doesn't she, Billy?
Yeah, mine looks like Hulk Hogan.
Come on, Billy. Why are you moaning? She's all right now. Don't you go do the phone call, Billy. I'm knackered with the Jennifer Lawrence one if you give her an 80 elbow.
I can't stand her though, Robbie.
What's wrong with her?
She's destroyed.
Well, it's dark in there, isn't it? Keep her out of the light and no one will notice our hunchback. Come on, I'd do the same for you, wouldn't I? Wouldn't I, Calf? I'm your mate, aren't I?
Yeah.
Well, I'm asking you to do me a favour.
Robbie's right, you know, Billy. You stand by your mates and they stand by you, don't they?
Yeah.
Oh, alright.
Good lads. Come on. Hey, it's great that Calf. Eddie be chuffed with you.
Boom! Yeah, I'm gonna tell him.
All right, girls. Oh, turn it on.
You must have no shame, that fella.
Well, I think she's a moral. I do. There's no need for that sort of behaviour. Not in the night before you're about to get married. Linda! Linda!
What, Bernie?
Do you not think you're being a bit inconsiderate?
Why is it that, Bernie?
Well, I could say I'm proper, Linda, but I won't. There is such thing as moderation, you know, Linda.
Why don't you tell me what's bothering you, Bernie?
Do you really think you should be going around like that with a stranger? The night before you're getting married?
He's not a stranger, Bernie. He's someone I know very well. You could call him an intimate friend.
Don't you try to take the piss out of me, Linda!
Bernie, I was dancing, that's all.
Linda, but you used to go out with him, didn't you?
Yes, Carol, I did.
So, do you not think that makes it worse?
No, Carol, I don't think it makes it anything.
I was dancing with someone I used to go out with.
I like him. I like him very much if it happens. And I think it's got feck all to you, or any of you.
Linda, have you forgotten that tomorrow you and Dave will be standing in the church getting married?
And what makes you think I'm still going ahead with it?
Why?
Maybe I didn't love you.
enough. They didn't half like
it. You always were a smooth-talking bitch, Linda. Anyway, I didn't necessarily mean with me in that sense. What are you going to do with that? Settle down here?
I might. Hey, I might have escaped your notice, but there are a lot of people who like living around here.
Including you?
Yeah.
Why?
Oh, get lost, you. Just because you live in London now doesn't give you the right to come back here and tell us we're all peasants. We do know where London is. Christ. You think you've gone to the other end of the world to hear you talk? It's only a short plane ride away.
Not when you've only got a one-way ticket.
Coming around here telling everyone what to do.
I'm not telling you what to do.
You think you can tell anyone what to do just because you wear fancy boots?
Oh, do what you like. I'm not telling you. Stay around here if you want, Linda. Have your kids and keep your mates and go dancing and go to the pub and go to the shops and do all the things you used to tell me you hated doing.
Get lost, you. I was young then. You do hate all those things when you're young, don't you?
And how old are you now?
22.
Oh, 22-year-old geriatric.
You're a bastard, you know that?
I know. I'm a selfish, shitty bastard. Because I did what I wanted to do. I did the worst thing possible. What I wanted.
And why should I get out?
Oh, come on, babe. Because you want it. Because while you're doing all this stuff, you hate it. You do it. But while you're doing it, you hate it. You want out of it.
Do you know something? You're the most arrogant, big-headed.
I know. But I'm right, aren't I?
No. You're just so arrogant, you think you're right. Anything that you want, it doesn't matter.
Why don't you pack it up here? When we finish up tonight, we're in the van on the way. Scotland tomorrow, Newcastle on Monday, on to Norwich and Southampton, a couple of gigs in Devon, then back to London. Come with us.
I gave you your answer a couple of years ago.
Oh, look, but then I was asking you to come with me. This time, babe, I'm just offering you a lift. You can get off wherever you like.
I never accept lifts from strange men.
Yeah, well, maybe you should.
Oh, should I now? Oh, God has spoken, has he? Well, listen, Mr. Know-it-all, it'd be great, wouldn't it? Speeding through Scotland with a second-rate band when there's 120 guests stood in a church tomorrow waiting to see me get married.
We're not a second-rate band. Seriously. Married.
Yeah. Why do you think I came here? It's the hen night.
Hen night? Oh, fuck. What? Did you want us to play congratulations? Or do you prefer getting to the church?
Just give us a kiss.
What you're saying.
Don't you listen? I told you. I'm getting married tomorrow.
I wasn't asking about that.
See you, Peter.
Right, yeah.
Thinks she's some sort of clever type, does she? We'll fucking sort her out, and her fancy fella as well.
You fucking cheap! Coming up here and nabbing Dave's board. He thinks he can take whatever he wants, doesn't he?
He'll think again when we finish with him. So, you want to get him while he's in here, right? Away from the rest of his posing mates.
Okay.
Oh,
All right, lads.
No sunshine. It's not all right, is it?
What?
What?
You just shut it. Are you a tyke? Hey, I asked you a question.
No, I'm not a tart.
Well, why have you got tart boots on?
I like them.
I don't.
No!
I don't like you either.
Yeah. Yeah, I gathered that.
Oh, had you then?
Well, listen, there's much fun.
You've been dancing around with our mate's tart.
What? Well, he's fucking lying sick in there.
And then, hold on, but why didn't
you been messing around with Dave's future missus?
And then, hold on!
No, you just hold on. Coming back here posing all over the place. Think you're someone special, don't you? Yeah? You think you can fucking do things that we can't, don't you? Well, I'll fucking show you what we can do.
Get off me!
That's what we can do. Look at it. Look.
I'm looking
good.
That's fucking clever, man.
I know.
Oh, do you?
Who did it?
Me.
Shut it.
It's good.
We can do anything.
Yeah. Did you go to art school?
Art school?
Art school?
This man's stupid, kid.
Hey, Cav, you could be an artist. Picasso, Kavanagh.
Picasso!
Cav, the artist. Ooh, can I hold your bushy feet, darling?
The only artist I want to be is a piss artist.
You stupid bastard!
Don't you dare! I'm going to tell you something for your own good. Don't you come around here with your music, your fucking music. Don't you come around here making people unhappy. Understand? We'll be watching you. You go near Dave's bird again, and your fucking number's up. Right?
Yeah. Whatever you say.
She's our mate's bird. We look after our mates. We stick with them. You left this town. You walked out. You've got no claims here. You left this town. So when you finish tonight, just fuck off out of here. Get out!
And don't you come back, you big pufter!
Right, let's find his tart. Come on.
Eddie! Can't find Linda anywhere.
Don't worry, we'll find her. Come on.
I wish Eddie would find me.
Fancy him, Bernie.
Well, I wouldn't say no to an hour.
Linda!
What are you lot doing in here? Why aren't you out dancing? There's not a lot of fellas left out there, Bernie, you know?
Go and tell Eddie she's here.
Hurry up.
You should be ashamed of yourself, Linda.
Why should I be, Bernie?
Ignore your mates, Linda. We don't matter to you. Do we, Linda?
For Christ's sake.
What are you on about now?
Look, you just listen to us for a minute.
Yes, Laura.
See? See?
Well, don't listen. You be selfish. You be a selfish bitch.
All right. Go on. I'm listening.
Listen to me for a minute, Linda. Now, I've been married quite a few years. You're forgetting. I understand. What's happening to you?
Well, go on.
Linda, there isn't one woman who doesn't have doubts the night before she gets married.
Bernie.
Don't interrupt me, Linda. Doubts, that's all they are. You can't go acting on feelings like that. Just because you're having some doubts, you can't go running into the arms of some ex-boyfriend and then disappear from
Bernie.
What if every woman did that? Who would be married today if we all took notice of how we feel?
Bernie! Can I get a word in now? Look, Carol. Look, all of you. For your information, I've got no intention of fucking.
Eddie, don't be daft. You can't go in there.
Get out of my way. Right.
Robbie.
You.
Hi, Robbie.
Come on, Eddie. You can't go in there. It's the ladies.
Get outside, I said.
I told you, Eddie. She won't listen.
All right. All right, stay in here. I'll stay as well. Get in here. It doesn't bother me, you know. I don't care that it's the fucking ladies. I said, get in here.
Oh, come on, Eddie. This is the ladies.
Eddie, we're in the women's jacks. Come on.
You stay where you are. What does it matter where it is? You don't worry about names on doors, do you? Names on doors don't bother me. I go where I want to go. Now, you listen to me. You might be Dave's bird, yes, but I'm his mate. I'm his best mate. He's our mate. You may try and treat him like shite, but we don't.
Eddie's right, you know, Linda. You are making a terrible show, Dave.
Going around telling people you're not marrying him? You don't treat a man like that, understand? You just learn a bit of respect and loyalty. And don't you go tell no one that you're not marrying Dave, because you are, tomorrow.
Oh, feck off, little man.
Don't you dare. Now, you listen to what I'm saying, love. You play awkward figures with me once more tonight, and I'll get that posing bastard you've been dancing with, and I'll break every figure he's got.
Stop.
Did you hear me? We've already seen him. He's been warned. And so have you. Did you hear me?
Yeah, all right, okay.
He's crap, you know. He can't even play the guitar. You think he's good, don't you? Well, he's not. I know about guitars. I play the guitar. Chords I play G and F and D minor.
Come on, Eddie, if we're seeing here.
You don't want to be impressed by him, though. He's all show. I could have been in a band, a famous band. I play the guitar. She's all right now. She's come to her senses, haven't you?
Yeah.
Come on, Eddie, we're the ladies.
Come on.
Right. See you in church. Come on, this way. Right. Get Dave over to the basin. Let's get him sorted out. We are out of here.
Eddie was right, wasn't he, Linda? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, Linda. Linda, thank goodness you've come to your senses.
I'm always telling you about your moods, haven't I, Linda?
Well, I'm just glad it's been sorted out now. Yeah. Come on now, Linda.
I didn't mean anything harsh, I might have said.
All friends now, yeah? There's a power. What's happening? It's okay, Mum. Everything's been sorted out now.
Oh, I'm glad. Hi, Linda.
Now we can go back to having a good night.
Oh, but listen, the band's not going to be playing.
What? Why?
I don't know. They just announced it. They're packing up. There's not enough power or something for their equipment.
Oh, I bet you I could put a bit of power back in their equipment. Lind?
Yeah.
What are we going to do now?
Why don't we go somewhere else?
What does Linda want to do? Well, Linda only wanted to come here because there was live music. If there's not going to be any, she won't mind moving on. Will you, Lind?
Let's go to Coppers.
Oh, will we? Yeah! Yeah, come on. Linda?
If you like.
I'll go and get the coats. Hurry up, let me get a taxi before the pubs start emptying.
Come on, Carol, I'll give you a hand.
Come on, I've had enough of this place. We're going to Coppers.
Come on, Dave! Dave! We're heading to Coppers! Have another few jars!
We'll have to get in there before 11, Dave, yeah?
Now! Eddie, give us help, give us help!
Right. Let's get outside. We'll get a taxi.
You alright, love?
Yeah, just feel a bit sick.
That'll be the drink, won't it? You'll be alright tomorrow. Be alright on the big day.
Come on!
Come on,
Dave. Oh God, Linda, close your eyes quick! Oh Jesus, skin, Linda!
Oh, thank God you can't see him. What a state! Don't bring him this way. We don't want tomorrow's riot seeing tomorrow's groom.
He can't see anything.
He's blind.
We'll just put him down there for a minute. I'll go see if I can get a taxi.
Do you need a hand, Eddie?
Yeah, whatever.
Come on, Dave.
That's it, Dave.
Yeah,
come on.
Get
a step.
Easy, Billy, easy. Come on, Dave. Come on, that's it.
Hi, Robbie.
Come on. Hi, girl. Come on. Hey, I was talking to Mike at a dance with you.
Were you?
Who's, looking after you?
No one.
No one? You mean no one's looking after a lovely young one like you? Well, you'll have to do something about that, won't you?
Hey, Robbie.
What?
You were only joking, weren't you?
Excuse me a sec. What?
You were only joking about the clap, weren't you?
Yeah. Now piss off. What? Piss off now.
Dave.
There's no taxis anywhere.
It's terrible, isn't it? Can't get one anywhere.
Your name's Cal, isn't it?
My real name's Tony. But they call me Cal.
Oh.
Hey.
What?
Come here.
What?
Give us a kiss.
You know, best mom.
Come here. Come on.
Well, fuck them all. They've gone. She's gone. But you've got no baggage weighing you down now, Dave. Come on, Dave. There's nothing holding us back now, Dave. We can go anywhere. Come on.
Come on.